If you're anything like us, you'll find repetitive processes can be tedious and time-consuming. Why should you have to do the same process over and over when you could just do it once and automate the rest? That's why we have DriveWorks. You can boost your productivity with DriveWorks by automating your designs in SolidWorks and maximizing your efficiency. We've worked with clients across the globe to tackle huge design and automation challenges. And over the years, we've developed ways to streamline their workflows and help them navigate their way to success. So, we've pulled together 10 of our most useful tips that are guaranteed to make your life easier when using DriveWorks. When dealing with any project, the first action is to envisage the end goal and plan out exactly what output is desired. Eliminate issues like project creep when working with DriveWorks by planning effectively and consulting the appropriate departments for a holistic view of technical functions to the user interface of the DriveWorks product configurator. Your plan may include setting up the SolidWorks models for DriveWorks, taking the tasks you perform day-to-day and applying logic through DriveWorks rules, documentation and other non-CAD items, or how forms will function within the user interface. If you're working with non-native CAD files like STEP or IGES files, then you'll need to modify them to get them ready for configuration in DriveWorks. There are a couple of options when working with imported models. You could recreate or modify the model in SolidWorks to make it configurable. However, we recommend another, simpler method. Instead, just create a subassembly containing multiple imported models within it. Then you can suppress and unsuppress the models to get the desired outcome. This subassembly method allows for extra flexibility, as supplier models may change over time. The rule builder within DriveWorks will be used by most users. It's a user-friendly tool which changes colors based on whether a rule is valid or invalid. However, there may be some scenarios where you wish to modify the user interface. If you or a user is colorblind, then modifying the background or text colors to be more accessible is vital. Other items that you can modify are font size and line numbers. And all of these can be changed within the rule builder settings. DriveWorks has some debugging tools for when things aren't quite working as expected. This might be a model not generating as expected, or a rule not evaluating as you thought. This is quite normal as you figure out the logic attached to your processes. If it's a rule not evaluating correctly, the rule builder would be the first place to check. Rules can be broken down into subsections to help pinpoint exactly which section of the rule is incorrect. If a specification has already been run and the outcome of the models or values aren't as desired, you can then delve into the reports. Specification reports list each job undertaken within the specification, and the model report will do the same for the model. You can filter for errors or warnings to make it easy. Specifications can also be troubleshooted in test mode. Test mode allows you to see how the specification runs in real time. DriveWorks allows you to reuse rules in multiple places through variables. By writing rules in variables, you only need to update the variable to propagate the change to wherever that variable is in use. You can then start to build more intelligence into shared rules through functions. When used correctly, the same rule can be applied in multiple places, but obtain different outcomes. And if you're looking for more advanced configuration, then rules can be nested within each other. Lookup tables can be used to help simplify this process, but these can get quite complex, so we recommend getting in touch with our DriveWorks consultants if this is an avenue you're considering. DriveWorks allows the use of calculation tables, which, unlike static tables, allow you to write rules for each cell or column. Each cell is then evaluated as you create your specification. Calculation tables are very powerful, but can take up useful resources and negatively impact performance. Because when a calculation table updates a value in a cell, the entire table is updated, regardless of how many rows and columns there are. So keeping your calculation table compact by minimizing rows and columns can help to retain the functionality of the table without being a drain on resources. Macro tasks and export functions can then be employed to increase the number of rows based on the specification currently being run. When setting up a project, consider a modular design to show information from other forms or projects. This can be done using a variety of form controls. Frame controls can maintain the layout on forms with headers and footers, while changing information on the main page without changing the current form. They can also be used to set the layout properties of controls on the form shown. Child specification lists allow you to start a specification of a different project from within the current specification. Child specification lists allow multiple specifications to be grouped under one top-level specification. And a specification host control allows specifications to be run within a window similar to a frame control, but it loads a new specification from a separate project. This can be useful for running projects asynchronously to allow autopilot to generate content in one specification while staying in a running state within a project. By breaking up the number of tasks to perform and reducing the amount of data stored within a project, you increase modularity. The 3D previews show the user exactly what will be generated on release of the specification without physically creating the SolidWorks model. It allows for a rapid representation to be shown on screen, and it can be modified along with form controls. Modifying the model with it is a little different to modeling in SolidWorks, despite the original file being saved from the SolidWorks master model. This is because it's a graphical representation, and the features that were configurable in the SolidWorks model aren't available. Scaling, movement, and replacements are all utilized instead. SolidWorks files should be saved as .drive3D files to be used in the 3D preview. Since this is a graphical file, the accuracy of the file is taken directly from the SolidWorks image quality settings. The higher the quality, the larger the file size. So before we save the .drive3D file, we should remove any unseen features from the model, reduce the resolution of some appearances, and reduce the image quality if possible. After developing a project within DriveWorks Admin, the next step is to run the project from DriveWorks Live and view the project from the web. You may then find that the scalability of the screen becomes quite important. To combat any layout issues, you can make use of the layout properties section of all form controls to create a hierarchy to set position and size. Within DriveWorks, there are two special variables, form container width and form container height, that determine the number of pixels available on screen. Using these variables, you can make sure that everything can scale to the correct size, no matter what size or resolution screen you're using. And before we reveal our number one top tip for working in DriveWorks, why not consider attending one of our DriveWorks training courses led by our expert SolidWorks engineers? Or get yourself a SolidWorks passport and learn all the skills you need to become a SolidWorks expert yourself. Click the link in the description to attend online or in a classroom near you. And don't forget to check out our other SolidWorks tutorials across our website and subscribe to our channel for more SolidWorks tips, tricks, and solutions. Now, modeling techniques in DriveWorks differ slightly from conventional SolidWorks modeling, and a core difference occurs within assemblies when mating components together. Where you might usually mate a face with a face or an edge to an edge, we need to replace those mates with a more robust and configurable method, mating to planes. We need to do this because you might be suppressing features, moving features, or splitting faces in different ways when configuring parts. Each of these modifications can result in the loss or changing of references, which may then cause an issue with the mate. By using planes instead, we remove that risk and ensure that our models are mated correctly every time. Similarly, avoid in-context modeling or referencing other parts or assemblies. When generating parts, master models are copied and re-referenced. And if modeling in context, then these references won't be updated to match the new parts. So those are our top 10 recommendations for working in DriveWorks. Which tips did you enjoy? And what do you want to see next? Let us know in the comments. If you're working with SolidWorks, remember that you don't have to do it alone. With a SolidWorks subscription, you gain access to our expert engineers who can guide you through your design journey. Whether it's training, support, or consultancy, our expert team are here to help you explore your options. So get in touch today. Find the details on screen.